am here to present my graduate seminar on the topic Artificial Intelligence in Agriculture and Plant Pathology. Following are the table of contents that will be discussed in the following presentation. History, Introduction, Artificial Intelligence in Agriculture, Artificial Intelligence in Plant Pathology, and Conclusion. As far as the history is concerned, a scientist named Alan Turing introduced a test called Turing test for testing the machine's intelligence in 1950. In 1956, the term artificial intelligence was coined by John McCarthy. The first lab of artificial intelligence was established at United States by the year 1959. The name of the artificial intelligence laboratory was MIT Artificial Intelligence. By the year 2011 and 2014, the personal assistants like Siri, Google Now, etc. were discovered, which are used for answering human questions and also help in performing various tasks. By the year 2013, an expert system called Prithvi was developed in Rajasthan, India by Prakash et al. So the question arises, what is artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence is made of two words, artificial and intelligence. Artificial means something that is man-made, and intelligence means something of human capability for answering human problems and making rational decisions. It is the science and engineering of making intelligent machines and programs that can stimulate intelligent processes such as learning, reasoning, and understanding so that it can think in rational manner, as such as human beings. The stages of artificial intelligence are there are three stages of artificial intelligence. The first one is artificial narrow intelligence, the second one is artificial general intelligence, and the third one is artificial super intelligence. The artificial narrow intelligence was developed till 2015. It involves machines that can perform a set of specific tasks. The second intelligence include artificial general intelligence, which is the evolution of artificial intelligence wherein machines possesses the ability to think and make decisions just like human beings. The third one is artificial super intelligence, which is the capability of computers which will surpass human beings. They will perform the task on their own. But we are somewhere between artificial narrow intelligence and artificial general intelligence. Robotics. Robotics is a branch of artificial intelligence which focuses on application of robots. Robots are artificial agents that act in a real world to produce results by taking accountable actions. One such example is Sophia, the humanoid. Artificial intelligence in agriculture. Agriculture is a backbone industry of any nation. It is time-consuming, labor-intensive, and money-intensive. Individual agricultural activities on the farm takes effort for planting, maintaining, and harvesting crops. Artificial intelligence is emerging as a part of solution towards improved agricultural productivity. It is mainly classified into three major categories. The first one is agricultural robotics, the second one is soil and crop monitoring, and third one is predictive analysis. Under agricultural robotics, drone technology is one of the important significance. It gives the agriculture industry a high technology makeover, planning and strategy based on real-time data gathering and processing. One such drone is called Yamaha multi-rotor drone, which is known by the name DJI MG-1S of 10 liter capacity. And the second one is spraying and spreading helicopters of Fazars, which is of about 32 liters capacity. The soil and field analysis is done by drones by producing 3D maps. It helps the farmers in planning cropping pattern in advance. It also helps in planting seeds and supplying nutrients to the soil, so that are essential for the development of plant. The drones also helps in spraying the crop with insecticides and pesticides. The crop monitoring can be done through time series animations. It shows the precise development of a crop and reveal production inefficiencies. It helps in better management of crop as well as planting system. The irrigation can also be managed through drones. The calculation of water requirement is done by the drones, and the water is supplied as and when required. The health assessment can also be done through drones. The plants which reflect different amount of green light and infrared light is detected by the drones, and the health could be detected and analyzed. A California-based machinery enterprise called Blue River Technology created a machine called See and Spray. The machine uses computer vision and artificial intelligence to detect and make management decisions about individual plants in the farmer's field, so that plants which are essential for farmers and consumers are not only unintentionally destroyed by the herbicide. The machine was robotic. The machine has robotic nozzles to ensure accurate spraying of herbicide. This technology is particularly used in cotton weeding. A Florida-based company called Harvest Crow Robotics developed an automatic harvester called Berify. It uses multiple multiple robotic components to perform functions of leaf gathering, visual inspection, and picking. They harvest the strawberry plant from the field, strawberries from the plant, and then help in packaging also. REPA, known by the name Robot for Intelligent Perception and Precision Application, was developed by Australian Centre for Field Robotics at the University of Sydney. It is an agricultural farming robot that runs on solar energy. It decides on the spot what to fertilize and what to eradicate. It uses a GPS system for moving in the fields. It covers for about 5 acres a day. It works 24/7 hours, particularly solving the problem of labor shortage in developed countries. In the sunny days, it can use on the battery so that solving the problem of solar energy. The smart weeding with Eco Robotics. Eco Robotics is a company which is based in Switzerland. It is fully automatic robot designed to destroy weeds. The robotic arms apply micro dose of herbicide in order to destroy weeds without hurting any crop. It also operates on solar energy and works for about 12 hours a day. Both the machines and robotics, both the robots, Eco Robotics as well as REPA, helps in reducing herbicide wastage and also herbicide resistance. This is the working principle of both Eco Robotics and REPA. The sensors which are located underneath the robot can examine the crop, and the data is collected. The data is then passed through various algorithms. The algorithms is converted into algorithmic model, which is thrown back into the robot, and then finally the robot is able to identify which is weed and which is crop using this model. The future of artificial intelligence in agriculture in India. In India, the farmers are very well aware of artificial intelligence technology, but they are not able to adopt it due to lack of knowledge as well as financial crisis. As far as the financial crisis is concerned, it can be managed by the help of government by renting machines, artificial intelligence machines to the farmers, and launching various schemes for the benefit of farmers so that artificial intelligence could be used in India. Artificial intelligence in plant pathology. Plant diseases have become a major threat to global food security. It not only reduces the agricultural production, but can also wipe out the whole crop. The abundant use of chemicals such as bactericides, fungicides, and nematicides to control plant diseases has been causing adverse effects in the agro ecosystem. There is a need for effective early disease detection for controlling plant diseases. With the proliferation of smartphones and recent advances in computer vision and machine learning, disease diagnosis based on automated image recognition could be made available. This is one such example where artificial intelligence is used in plant disease diagnosis. The GDDS system, that is known by the name Grape Disease Detection System, using machine learning algorithm is used. The grapevine is employed with sensors which sends the signals to the sensor. The sensor collects the data, and if a problem is detected, the user is notified by sending a SMS. This system was developed by Patil and Thorat in the year 2016. It employs various sensors such as temperature sensors, leaf fatness sensors, and humidity sensors in the vineyard. This server reports any aberration in temperature, humidity, or leaf fatness, which can result in grape diseases to farmers. This system is very effective in identifying the grape disease detection, but it can also help in suggesting various management procedures to the farmer. The farm-made board. It uses a donkey car platform. The donkey car platform is a fully automated platform where the car drives itself. It is an autonomous robot that can move in farm environment without damaging existing plants or soil and use object detection to find and mark diseased crops with an environmentally safe color. The following color indicate when the green color is produced, it shows that the crop is perfectly healthy. If the red color is produced, then the crop is declared diseased. When it shows yellow color, then it shows that the plant is dried up, and the blue color indicates an unknown reason. In the upcoming slides, the mobile application which are useful in detecting the plant diseases will be discussed. It will also help in suggesting various management practices. Plantix app. It is a disease diagnostic app which is developed in Germany by a scientist called Robert Stray under the organization named PEAT. PEAT stands for Progressive Environmental and Agricultural Technologies. When a user simply takes a picture of diseased plant and send it to PEAT server, the user's letter detection result within seconds. The protection measures such as chemical, biological, physical, and mechanical is also suggested to the farmers by the PEAT server. And another application called Zarvio Scouting is a multifunctional application. It helps in disease identification, single weed identification, multi weed identification, crop emergence analysis, nitrogen status, and leaf damage analysis. Another such application is Plant Village Nuru. It is an application which was developed by Penn State University with the collaboration of Indian Institute of Tropical Agricultural Culture Organization. It uses a digital assistant to help farmers diagnose crop diseases in the field without an internet connection. The app is based on extensive research comparing the accuracy of machine learning models to human experts and extension work. Continual research keeps the app constantly updated. Crop Doctor application is also such an application of Android. It is an Android-based mobile application which is developed by Indira Gandhi Krishi Vishwavidyalaya, Raipur, Chhattisgarh. It diagnoses the disease, insect, and nutrient deficiency of major pulses, cereals, vegetables, and oilseeds. This is how when a user sends an image, disease is diagnosed. The image is acquired, and the segmentation is done using edge detection technology. The photo is processed, and the feature is extracted from the cloud. At the last, the image is classified. By the end of 2050, it is expected that the population of human will reach up to 9 billion. Under such circumstances, the agriculture production will be of high demand. In such circumstance, the artificial intelligence technology will play its role. It will not only help in increasing agricultural production, but it can also help in saving time and money of the farmers. Thank you.